Thank you. Good morning. Mix that on. To please come inside because there are seats there, and those relatives of the late Lenford, Pastor Lenford Matthews, you're asked to sit as close as possible so that those who are coming in late can have a sitting and the service is not disturbed. Relatives, nieces, nephews, cousins, please fill up the section that is earmarked for relatives and friends. Precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his saints. We're going to begin this period of tributes, and I now invite Harrietta Andrews, the sister of the dead departed, to bring her tribute at this time. After Harrietta's finished, we'll invite Pastor Amos Denny, who's a special friend and colleague in the ministry, to do his tribute.
Come this way.
Lenford Matthews, the son of Estella, the late Estella Drusilla Andrews. We have Clementina Andrews, Edith and Richard, Erila Farilla Andrews, Nola Evelyn Andrews, Lenford Matthews, and Harrietta Andrews, and the last, Anita Andrews. Sorry, Anita cannot be here today, but she asked me, please, sister, don't forget to say something on her behalf. Now, I'd like to read this poem It's hope I can. My brother Lenford has called upon
you today.
You today, leaving so many words to say, but now it's too late, for your time has come. Words unspoken, I'm sure everybody has some. Regrets and wishes are probably there too, but lasting forever are memories of you. There has been times that we disagreed, but we were there for each other in time of need. You are loved by so many. You are loved by so many you might not have known, but in our hearts is where you have grown. I will miss you, brother. You owe so much. I will
With all the lives you have touched,
now it's time for me to say goodbye, my brother, until we meet again in heaven to fly. Brother, rest in peace.
Amen. Pastor Denny?
Thank you, Madam Chair. It is with great delight I welcome this opportunity to be with you this morning as we celebrate the life and times of a friend, a brother, and a fellow co-worker in the kingdom of God. The late Lenford, Pastor Lenford, Matthews. My first recollection of meeting him, I believe I was about 16 years old at the time, and we met at the Kingston Evangelical Church on afternoons. Several young men from the rural areas, and we'll go to the Kingston where they had a building, a table tennis board, and we will play tennis, draft, dominoes, and cricket, and of course football. Pastor Matthews, from my observation, is a man who truly fears God and served him with a passion. He's 11 years my senior. He's a very generous person. I would have developed this friendship. We would have developed this friendship and lasted over a period of 60 years. Pastor Matthews believed in the institution of marriage and the family. When I met him, he was already married. And all of us know the testimony of a truly true servant of God. Here was otherwise known or affectionately known as Cap Matt, our skipper, because he loved cricket, and in fact he was the captain many times when we played cricket together. He worked hard in the service of God and here in Biabou in particular, to the extent where he was elevated to the pastoral office and served for many years. He would be greatly missed. It is said that heaven's gain is earthly loss. Pastor Matthews was truly committed as a family man, a community man. But most of all, he was a born-again Christian and looked forward to this day with great expectation and hope. I'm very confident that he's in a place that God has provided for him. As I close, because I told I only have 2 minutes, I believe I have exceeded that. But I wish to take this opportunity on behalf of my family to extend to Sister Matthews and the entire family our sincere condolences. May God bless him and may he rest in peace. God bless you.
Thank you, Pastor Denny. We're going to hear tributes from sister-in-law Monica Thomas, and then by a special friend, Cornelio Walker.
Good morning to all, and thank you, dear nieces, for allowing me the opportunity to reflect on some of the good memories of my brother-in-law, Pastor Lenford Matthews. These are memories that will never leave me. They will never leave my mind until my death. These memories of Cap Matt helped to mold and shape my character, thus making me a stronger individual. You might have heard me refer to him as Cap Matt. That's because of the bond we share. Whenever we greeted each other, he called me Mon, and I called him Cap Matt, for he was my friend. I cannot remember if Pastor Matthews was already married to my sister, but I vividly remember Cap Matt taking us as little children on those journeys to New Prospect every Sunday afternoon to attend Sunday school classes. Irina, Suzanne, Diane, and myself went along with him. Cap Matt took very good care of us in those days. When I became an adult and was faced with difficult situations I could not handle on my own and needed advice but was not sure who to turn to have that certain level of conversation, the Almighty directed me to talk to Cap Matt. And boy, oh boy, how refreshed, relieved, and comforted I felt after our discourse. Pastor Matthews was my mentor. He was my friend. He helped me to make better decisions in different aspects of my life. Katmat truly cared for others. And from my observation of him, once he found favor in someone, he opened up and he talked. Otherwise, he spoke when he was spoken to and remained silent when he had to. Proverbs 31 verse 10 asks this question. A virtuous woman, who can find? Her price is far above rubies. I think men are also virtuous because Katmat was one of those men. He was a wise man, and his price was far above rubies. When Katmat spoke, his words were impactful. He left an impact on people after preaching, praying, and leading song services. Those tasks were his passion, and he executed them with vigor and gladness. When I was part of this assembly, Evangelical Church of the West Indies, I looked forward to hearing him preach and lead song services. He was also a sharing individual. He shared his produce from his land with families and friends and never anticipated anything in return from anyone. My mother loved him a lot, and he took good care of her. He ensured she got home safe after night meetings. During her illness, he helped her a lot. He visited her regularly and kept her company, and that meant a lot to her. When she died, we entrusted her burial arrangements into his capable hands. And he willingly took that burden off our shoulders and executed that task faithfully and selflessly. I too placed my business into his care. As a matter of fact, he was my power of attorney. He was the best. He was such an honest man. Katmat was a good man, and we were blessed to have him in our family. I miss him a lot, and I know that void is going to remain in my heart for a long time. May his soul rest in peace.
Myself. Let me say good morning to everyone that's here. I ask this opportunity to say a few words, tribute to my dear friend. He's indeed my very good friend, and it saddens me. I can believe it to sadden the hearts of his children, his wife, that he has passed. Katmat and I became very close friends, you know, always close friends. He was my pastor. We were always friends. He was my pastor, mentored me. I looked up to him for instruction and support. But he became my very close friend within the last 5 years.
apart from meeting each other at the regular church meetings, we attended men's fellowship that was conducted by a brother, Marcus Cain, and we played dominoes, among other things. One of the things that a brother was asked to do by a brother Cain was to pray for us. But we played dominoes, and we had a good time at the end of, at some point in playing, he was asked to pray, and the captain did that, as usually, gracefully. But he didn't have that competitive spirit that most of us played with. He played, just excuse me, let's see. My glasses will improve the situation. Okay. So where am I? He played If you play this partner wrong, a bad shot, he never and just excuse me, just get this part right. And his father brings it to his attention. He just listens and says nothing. He never argued with his partner whether he was right or wrong. I wish that more persons would adopt that approach generally in life. He was a remarkable man, someone to emulate. He enjoyed our company, and we were glad to have him. We looked forward to having him join us on Saturdays, on Saturday evenings. We have missed him already. During the period of the pandemic and the eruptions of last April, Susanna, Charlene, and Daphne supported the family. Supported the family. Tremendously, sorry, by sending boxes and barrels of food and the likes, every so often. He had my cell phone, my cell number, and I had his number, and he would call me and ask my assistance, which I consented invariably. I was always willing to go the extra mile for him. He won that place in my heart. I did pretty much several things for him, including transporting him to the doctor and the hospital, Georgetown, to Bunkay, where he had his lands, to his home from church on Sunday, etc. His doctor, Dr. Martinez, who attended to him, gave him a clean bill of health just prior to his incident at home. He came to the men's fellowship on the Saturday and announced with glee that the doctor had given him a clean bill of health and said that she would see him in January 2023. Turned out that is not possible. Tamar worked very hard over the years, planting various crops to take care of his family. but not without many challenges and discouragements. He suffered loss through period larceny, dishonesty of traffickers, etc. 3 years ago, he reaped some yams and secured them in the field. He returned the next day, only to find that they had gone. Someone had stolen them. Drought, rodents, pests, fungus, and bacteria also contributed to this significant loss at times. Yet still, despite these challenges, he kept on doing what generous, kind, and trustworthy. Whenever I needed some gum provision to send to my brother in St. Martin, he never accepted any money from me. He would say, "Brother, that's yours." So he had a symbiotic relationship. He often said to my wife and me that reminded him of Brother Miners and his wife. The benefit of those who don't know Brother Miners, or the person he made reference to, that they were two persons, they were two outstanding Christians who lived in Biabou at the time, who were kind and helpful in the community. Kamat walked okay. He told me in January or February of this year that he had enough of farming at Bunkane that he was contemplating selling the land. He had not entirely given up the farming, but just stood back of his house. He planted some plantains. This remarkable man's routine of journeying from Biabou starting at 5:30 on the morning had come to an end. He went to town. The doctor, the bank, all right, I'm coming to you. Let me just finish up here. Eh? All right, having problem seeing to it, that's the problem. Okay, his wife, Virginia, children, Susanna, Charlene, Daphne, Hilton, and Lenny, along with many others, will miss him greatly. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Brother Walker. The next two tributes we hear from a special friend and from on behalf of the community of Biabou would be done by Augustus Woodley, special friend, and then by the Honorable Frederick Stevenson. I'll encourage all of us to listen and allow the persons paying their tribute to do so respectfully. It's not easy to be up here standing. And if you would have put yourself in that position, you would have been facing a similar fate. Thank you.
Greetings, everyone here.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
I know the name on your sheet, Augustus Woodley, have baffled many of you. But I'm the same Eustace Harry you knew, growing up in this Biabou here with many of my friends. It's an honor to be here today just to offer condolences to the families, friends, and loved ones of the deceased. May I say, sometimes when unexpected and unexplained circumstances occur in our lives, the natural tendency is to ask, why does these things happen? But the Bible has the answer. According to Deuteronomy 29:29, the secret things belongeth unto the Lord. And those things he reveals, he reveals. And those things he chooses to conceal, he conceals. I'm here and feel very honored to say a few words on behalf of my oldest and best friend who I ever knew, Mr. Lenford Matthews. We shared many social and spiritual times together. And my name, I always call him Captain Matthews, but never knew he was the captain of a cricket team. From my observation, I saw a man who walked with God consistently. A man who worked for God unceasingly. And the man who looked forward for his great reward or his wages at the great judgment seat of Christ. If Mr. Matthews was able to speak before his death, and members of the family and friends were to surround his bedside and ask the question, are you prepared to meet your God? I believe these would have been his words. The time of my departure is at hand. I am ready to meet my Maker. Amen. I have fought a good fight. Amen. I have finished the work that God has given me to do. Amen. I have kept the faith. Amen. May my brother's soul rest in peace. Amen. And may God bless you all.
Pleasant good morning to the leadership of the church here at the Biabou Evangelical Church, the wife and children of our departed brother, Brother Lenford Matthews, residents of this community of Biabou and the surrounding areas, and those of you who are visiting from other communities, and I see persons who have traveled from overseas who are here, and those who are viewing the service live. I have known Mr. Matthews since I was a little boy. When my mother worked at the boxing plant around the hole there, as little children, we used to have to go and wait for our mother until 1 o'clock in the morning, 2 o'clock in the morning, 3 o'clock. And I used to have fun sliding down the chute that the boxes, after the guys built them, would shoot them down, and the persons who were packing the bananas would take them as they need. As time went by, going up to Simon with my father, you'd see Brother Matthews going or coming from his lands in Bunkane. respected farmer in the community. As I grew much older and started to work, I remember one Christmas, I wanted some Portuguese yam to cook a soup, Christmas boil up with your cattle skin and your cattle head and so on. And somebody said to me while I was down the road, the only person that you can either get the Portuguese yam from or the Dominic yam was Mr. Matthews. So I went up into the village and I bought some and he gave me some. That was the kind of individual Brother Matthews was. As a child, I came to this church from time to time when they had summer programs and listened to Brother Matthews offering words of comfort and kindness to the children who gathered for the summer programs. As I grew older, coming to funerals and coming to services here, Brother Matthews was to me a very outstanding preacher. He never used words that the ordinary person couldn't understand. His sermons were very simple but profound in meaning. After his sermons, I don't know how many persons would go home or reflect, but I used to do so. Reflect on his messages. Brother Matthews was a well-respected member of this Biabou community and the community in which he lived, and in St. Vincent and the Grenadines. And so today, on behalf of the community of Biabou, the constituency of South Windward, which I am presently the parliamentary representative, and on behalf of the government of St. Vincent and the Grenadines, I extend to his wife and the children and the other family members our sincerest condolences. May his soul rest in peace. Thank you.
You have been given a foretaste of the person who held the positions of husband, brother, father, grandfather, uncle, cousin, pastoral leader, caregiver, a community-spirited person. We give thanks to all those who would have shared, and we thank you for sharing with us briefly the person who Uncle Lenford was. At this time, I'm going to allow us, ask us to view happier times of our dear departed.
Thank you. My eyes shall behold and not another. God is our refuge and his strength, a very present help in trouble. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous runneth into it and is safe. Lord, thou hast been our dwelling place in all generations. Before the mountains were brought forth, or even though has fallen the earth and the world, even from everlasting to everlasting, thou art God. He that dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. And I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress, my God, in him will I trust. Indeed, great is his faithfulness. And I will always remember Pastor Matthews for his faithfulness. It's a blessing indeed that we, sinful men, with time, effort, can at least have a little of the image of God in us. He served this church. He served our denomination. He did it in a very humble, very faithful, constant way. We, the Evangelical Church, Biabou Evangelical Church family, we are grateful to all of you who has come, traveled, leave your churches this morning to be here with us. As we say farewell, not as we don't say goodbye. This is the hope that we have. This is the life and testimony that he left among us. We shall see him again. In the meantime, let memories be kept. For all of you who travel from England, Canada, America, we welcome you. Thank you for being here with us. Thank you for being with the family. We are grateful to you. Let's remember him today with joy, happiness, sadness too, grief too, but with hope. Hope we shall see him again. I invite you please to, if anybody is have a device connected to the internet in the church, please I ask you to log out your device. We need all the internet speed to be able to stream the service. So please, all of you who have devices and can connect it to the internet in the church, I ask you, please log out your devices. And after the service and the funeral, the family want to spend some time in quiet. So solicitude, please allow them to grieve. So let's have a word of prayer before we hand over to Brother Marcus King, who will be our moderator for this service. Father, we are standing before you with gratitude in our heart. Gratitude for life. And gratitude for death. Lord, when death comes with eternal life, because we know that our end is not in the grave. But there is a river. And beyond Jordan, this is a marvelous city. And every one of us who has set our faith and trust in you, we know we will not cross that river alone, but you take us in your arms to the place when we can rest in your presence. Now, as we say farewell to Pastor Matthews, and as we remember him, Lord, as we sing and celebrate your goodness and your mercies, with a sense of sadness too and mourning in our heart, we give you thanks for his life. Each one that is here today somehow has been touched by his life. And we thank you for the many others who are not here, and even for the many others who already has welcomed him because they passed before. And while they celebrate together, Lord, in your presence, when we are left behind with a sense of sorrow, we thank you. Thank you. Receive all the glory and the honor. Yes, Lord. And all the praise. Yes, Lord. Because you are the center. Yes. And everything revolves around you. Glory and honor be unto you. Yes. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor. Sir. We sing this hymn of the faith to say to our Jesus that we love him because he gifted us with Lenford Matthews for 85 years, and we have benefited from his life, and we are exceedingly grateful to God for having loaned him to us for that long. Let's sing together. My Jesus, I love, I love, for thee, all
for which we are gathered here. We are gathered to praise God, to tell God how much we love him and appreciate him for the life of our departed Pastor Lenford Matthews. And brethren, faithfulness to the word of God and followed on with that legacy of godly conduct. And I want to just say briefly that just as much as we need godly leaders, it is also necessary that we have godly followers. And if we get nothing else from today's service, it should be that Lenford Matthews' life, the legacy has left us, motivates us to be godly followers. You see, leaders don't need to be perfect, but they should be able to show with their life that the power of Jesus is real, as it imparts and transforms the individual's life. And I know that Jesus transformed the life of Lenford Matthews, hence he impacted all of us. And we are so thankful for him. And that demonstrates a faith that can actually be followed, as the writer of the Hebrews tells us. Obey those. He asks us to, in Hebrews chapter 13 and verse 7, he tells us that we must obey those, not obey. We must reflect on those who have led us, and that we must consider the life that they have lived and follow after them. And I have followed after this pastor for many years, 48 years. His children have followed after him. The local church here has followed after him. Many members of the community have followed after him. But there are those who have fallen and have returned to their old ways. If you get nothing else from today, it is a call to follow after the testimony and the legacy that Pastor Matthews has left us. So we're going to have our first scripture reading from the Gospel of St. John, chapter 14, verses